This session talks about tuples. Now, what are tuples? Tuples are simply like list, they are sequence data object. Tuples are sequence data object, and they can collect, like list, they can collect heterogeneous data object separated by comma. Right? A tuple unlike list are immutable. What is the main difference between list and tuple? The main difference between list and tuple is that tuples are immutable. They are what? They are immutable. That means once a tuple is created, we can not insert anything inside that tuple. We cannot take out or delete or extract from that particular tuple. So any algorithm requiring the deletion or addition of elements in the tuple will not run with tuples. So once created, the elements within that tuple cannot be modified, right? Now let us see the syntax of tuple. As you can see, there are three examples on before you on the screen. And these three examples are t is equal to 12, 16, 19. That is one tuple. Then we have n is equal to a, b, c, p, q, r, r, s, t. That is a tuple of strings over here. These are tuples of integers. And this is a tuple of mixed tuple having all sort of data types. Now let us move on to the next slide and find out. Creating a tuple. How to create a tuple? Just like we have created list, tuples can also be created. They can also be created. Tuples can also be created just like lists. Okay. And what is the syntax for creating the tuple? The syntax for creating the tuple is as shown in your before you on the screen. This is the syntax for creating a tuple. Now, how the tuples are created? They are created. Using syntax t is equal to and then parenthesis. Just writing t is equal to parenthesis will create a tuple. Okay. Now the second example, q is equal to 236, creates a tuple with initial values 236 with three elements, right? And writing r is equal to q means what? R is a new tuple being assigned q. That means now R and Q will share the same memory, as like with the case of lists, they will share the same memory. So any changes made in Q will be reflected in R. Tuples are immutable, so no changes can be done at all. Though they are sharing the same memory, but no changes can be done at all. That means what? Simply that memory area has two names now, R and Q. So either it can be referred with a R name or it can be referred with a Q name. Okay, so that is very, very important point here to understand. Now let us go for the next thing. Let us find out example of writing these codes, right? So we'll see how we can write examples. Let's find out. We will now do a sample code on creation of tuples. So tuples are created using t is equal to blank parenthesis that I have told you earlier. Or it can be created like q is equal to 2 comma 3 comma 4 like this. When you print q, it will show you values within parenthesis or first bracket, right? So that is what is tuple. Now what more can be done in this tuple? Let us find out. If I am going to apply operators on this tuple, say for example plus operator, whether this plus operator will be applicable on this tuple or not, let us find out that. So if I'm writing t is equal to suppose 5 comma 6 comma 7 and then I am going to print r is equal to t plus q, what do you think will happen here? Whether it will give an error or it will do the thing, let us find out what will happen. In case of list, it just adds two lists and give the concatenated list. Here, let us find out what happens. Here also, it has done it. That means it has concatenated the two tuples. Let us find out whether the resultant tuple is having the elements from both the tuples t and q or not. Now you can see that r is having 5, 6, 7, 2, 3, 4. This 5, 6, 7 is from t and 2, 3, 4 is from q. So t plus q, that means both the tuple elements have been concatenated, have been added to a single tuple r, right? And the tuple r is created. So hence this shows that plus operator can be used with between tuples, right, to concatenate two or more tuples. Now let us find out whether plus equal to operator is applicable on tuples or not. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make another tuple called f and making it as 1 1 1, right? And then what I'm doing, I'm writing r is equal to r plus f, or rather I can write r plus equal to f, isn't it? R is equal to r plus f can be written as r plus equal to f. Now let us find out what it does to the value r. But before that, let us find out the id of r. The id of r is 43813919936. Just remember this so that we can compare what happened to the id after this addition or plus equal to operator, application of plus equal to operator. So if I'm writing r is equal to r plus equal to f, that means r is equal to r plus f. Let's find out whether it is applicable or not. Yes, it is applicable. As you can see that it is applicable. If I am going to write r plus equal to f, that is applicable. It has done it. The compiler has accepted this statement. Now let us find out what is the changes in r. Value of r is the 111 has been concatenated with the r, right? So that r plus f is the resultant value. So r is having all the elements from its own tuple as well as the tuple f. Now let us find out what happened to the id of r, whether it is same or it has changed. Bingo, here you go. That what is that? You have two different ids, right? You have two different ids. Just look on here. When the r was initially, the r was having this id, but finally r is having a separate id, a different id. Now this shows that the immutability of tuples. It shows immutability of tuple. Though it is applicable, though plus equal to operator is applicable, but it does not create these, it does not places these 111 at the same memory location where all these things were earlier placed. That means whatever was the earlier memory location of r, at that location this 111 has not been added. What the compiler did, it created a fresh memory location. At that fresh memory location, it concatenated all the elements and changed that location name to r. So r is having now a new location, but the existing location is still there in memory. This location is still there in memory, having only these elements 5 6 7 2 3 4. So you must remember this, that whenever we are changing the value in a tuple using plus operator or plus equal to operator, actually a new memory location is created. Just like in case of simple integers, strings, floats, etc. Why? Because they were immutable. Let us find out whether this same thing happens in list or not. Let us find out. L is equal to 4, 5, 6. And then I have y is equal to 1, 1, 1. Let us check first what is the id of L. It is showing something like this. Now let us write this expression, L plus equal to y. Now let us check id of L again. Now as you can see, what is the main difference here? Nothing has been changed. Now let us see whether the changes are being done on L or not. Let us find out. Yes, the L has been changed, but memory location is not changed. Memory location is still the same. This is the main difference when you are dealing with lists and tuples. Let me again explain it. In tuples, when we are doing this type of operation, the initial memory location just changes to another place because of the changes in the tuple due to plus equal to operator. So actually there is no change in the original tuple at all is correct. It is still holding that theory. But in case of lists, this doesn't happen. List initially has certain things. Another list has been added to that further list. It just manipulates the same memory location and adds the element just after the last element, but the location remains same. As you can just see here, the before doing this operation the memory address was this, after doing this operation the memory address is same. But in case of tuples, before doing this operation the memory address was this, after doing this operation the memory address changed to this. So this is how the operations differs in tuples. Though tuples are permitting plus equal to and plus operator, but they are acting very differently as in case of lists. Let us move on. Why tuples? Why we need at all tuples? So you might have a question that, sir, when we have lists, why there is a need of tuples? My question is, why tuples? When we have list, why tuples? So let us find out why we need tuples, right? There are many programming scenarios where tuples are preferred over lists because of its immutability. So due to that, it has a special place in some situations. In some scenarios of programming, it has some special place too. Due to immutability, we cannot add or delete values from the tuple, and that is what is the specialty about the tuples. We cannot add and delete the elements from the tuples, right? And hence, any situation that demands a static fixed collection of items, which is rarely going to be changed during the programming, will need tuples. Tuples may be used where we do want to create and read-only lists. So tuples are also known as read-only lists. There is another name for tuple that is called read-only lists. That means you can perform only read operation on the lists tuples, but cannot perform write operations on tuples. It is only for read-only operations that we are preferring tuples. Okay. Now list versus tuples. This is the list versus tuples. Let us find out point by point. The first point is, can't add elements to a tuple. We cannot add elements to a tuple. Tuple have no append, insert or extend functions. So these three important functions which were applicable on lists are no more available with tuples. Append, insert, extends are not available with the tuples. So tuples have no append, insert or extend functions, right? The second point is can't remove elements from a tuple. Tuple have no remove or pop function. Neither del keywords is applicable to tuples. So tuple does not allow append, insert, extend. It also not allows remove, pop or del keyword to be applied on it. So we don't have remove, pop or del keyword applicable to tuples. The third point is, can't perform sort, reverse, clear over tuples. So you cannot have apply these functions on tuple. Tuple does not have these functions. Sort for sorting alphabetically or whatever. Reversing the tuple. Can I ask you why sort and reverse are not applicable to tuple? Listen. Very carefully listen, all of you. When we are doing any type of sorting operation, as you have seen in class 11, bubble sort. Yaad hai na, bubble sort dekha tha. Aur selection sort dekha tha. Right? So any sort of sorting operation requires reassignments of elements. Reassignment, ek element ko uske previous element se reassign karna padta hai. Matlab iska place udhar, uska place idhar. Swapping karna padta hai. And this swapping requires reassignment. And no reassignment is allowed on tuples. Since no reassignment is allowed on tuples, we cannot add or delete elements. Right? Now let us do it. Let us check it out using this IDLL. So we have things like, as you can see, let us perform a equal to operation on tuples. Let us perform an equal to operation on tuples. Okay. So t is equal to 3, 5, 8, 9. Now this is tuple. Now let us find out whether we can do this thing or not. T at 0 is equal to 78. T at 0 is equal to 78. That means I want to replace 3 with 78. Now you can see that tuple object does not support item assignment. Type error is coming. Just note down this error. Type error is coming. Tuple object does not support item assignment. So this is what is a mischief being done with tuples, that whenever you are going to assign any value to a particular index, it will not accept as it is immutable. tuples are immutable. So this type of operation, the equal to assignment operator, does not works with elements of the tuples. List versus tuple. Let us concentrate on the fourth point. The fourth one is tuples are faster than lists. If we just want to use constant set of values in our program. So this is a very, very important difference, that tuples are a bit faster than list if we want to just use constant value in our program. So suppose you want to use fixed values in your program, then tuple will be efficient than lists, right? They will perform better in comparison with lists because we don't have to change any values. Right? Next is, tuples can be used as dictionary key as they are immutable. As we will see in further in our revision class, that when we will deal with dictionary, that dictionaries have two things, key and value. Key value pair is there in dictionary, right? So the key value pair, the key will be always an immutable data object. In a dictionary, the key should be always a immutable data object. So tuple can act as a key, whereas list cannot act as a key of a dictionary. So that is also one of the important difference. Now let us find out the similarities of tuples with list. Though they are different, they are similar to. Tuples are similar to the lists. Now what are the similarities of tuples with lists? Can perform a search within tuple using index function. So you can apply index function on the tuples. You can search any element using index function on tuple. We will see that in the practical session. Second point is, can use in operator to check if element exists in the tuple. In operator is applicable, like in case of list, you can use in to check whether a particular thing exists in a list of tuple or not. The third point is, we can use plus and plus equal to operator, as we just have seen that in our practical session. We can use plus and plus equal to operator to concatenate a tuple with another tuple, just like lists. But this concatenation results in alteration of memory location of original tuple in question. So alteration of memory location happens when you are doing plus and plus equal to operation with tuples, right? The fourth point is, like list, tuple supports functions like length, max, mean, sum, count, index, and enumerate. All these functions are applicable to tuples. And the last point is very, very important. Like list, tuples can also be sliced. They can be sliced. How to slice a tuple? By using this syntax. The syntax can be seen. The last line is showing the syntax. Syntax is tuple name, and then in the square bracket, start, end, and step. So lists are similar to tuples because all these functions are applicable on the tuples. It is similar to functions, tuples, because many functions like which demands changes in the element are not applicable on the tuples. So now we are going to find out which are the functions which are applicable on tuples, which are the functions which are not applicable on tuples, as we have discussed earlier. So the first set of functions which are not applicable to the tuples, let us find out them. So we have insert, we have remove, we have extend, we have append. Let us find out whether we can apply those things on tuples or not. So t is equal to something, say for example 78, 56, 45, 90. We have this thing, and then I am going to apply t dot append 23. I want to add 23 at the end of this list, this tuple. Let me find out. Now you can see attribute error. What, which type of error is being shown? Attribute error is reported. What is attribute error? There is no such attribute called append with tuples. So tuples does not allows append operation, right? So this is the error which we are finding out. Suppose if we want to extend the tuple with certain more values. Let us extend the tuple with few more values, 45 and 6. Again, the tuple object does not have, so tuple object has no attributes called as extend. There's no such attribute called extend in tuples, right? Now again, let us find out whether we can apply t dot remove 56. Suppose I want to remove 56. Let us find out whether we can remove it or not. Again, the same thing happened Tuple objects has no attribute remove. There is no such attribute called remove which can be applied. Let us find out whether we can use insert function in the tuples or not. So t dot insert, and then index, we have to pass the index, third index. In the third index, I want 33 to be placed. Again, the error is there, insert function is not applicable. So with this, we can understand that there are many functions which are applicable on list are not applicable to tuples. Since it is demanding what? It is demanding change in the values. And that is why it is not allowable. Now let's find out which are the functions which are like lists which are applicable to tuples. Let's find out the length of this tuple, t, length of this t. Now as you can see, the length of t gives you 4. That means the length function is applicable to a tuple. Max of t gives you 90. So applicable to tuple. Then we have mean of t. So it gives you mean of tuple. We can have sum of t. That is okay. That can be given. Sorry. Sum of t. It gives you 269. So all these functions are applicable to tuples. So these functions are applicable to tuples, right? Similar to lists. Now in lists we have some functions like index, to find out index of an element. Whether that element exists in the list or not, I want to find out. So suppose for example 56, if 56 in t print present, else absent. Let's find out what is there. Present, it shows you present because it is the in operator is applicable to tuple. The in operator is applicable to tuple, right? So you can use in operation with tuples. So 56 in t. So this is applicable with tuples. Now let us find out whether index function is applicable to tuple or not. So t dot index of, I want to find the index of 56. And this gives us 1. That means the 56 is the second element in the tuple. Let us find out. Let us see our tuple. This is our tuple. The index of 56 is here is 1. Okay. 0, 1. So that is correct. So index function is applicable to tuple. Let us find out whether enumerate function is applicable to tuple by writing for i in enumerate t. And then print I. Now you can see here all the values 78, 56, 45, 90 has been enumerated with 0, 1, 2, 3. So enumerate function is also applicable on tuples. So these are the similarities of tuples with that of lists. So I hope with this example you are able to understand the similarities and dissimilarities of tuples with list. And here is the example exercise 1 for you to do right now. This example exercise has to be done. I will solve one by one these examples, and then we will have certain questions for you to solve. And you can write the code at your end also, no problem, no issue with that. And just at the end, match your solution with my solution, right? So just start writing the solutions for this. Take the screenshot of this question, these questions. Start writing one by one. And you can just match your solution with my solution. The first question is, write a program to input a tuple from user and convert it into a list. So the question demands that you have to input a tuple from user and convert it into a list. So we can have this type of syntax where we can write t is equal to list over something. And here I can pass a tuple. Inside this list, we can pass tuple so that the t becomes a list. The tuple becomes a list. So this problem demands this type of thing. So write a program to input tuple from user and convert it into list. Second problem is write a program to input a tuple and reverse it. Now this is very interesting thing. If we want to reverse this tuple, you should attempt this question because direct reverse function is not applicable. Let's find out whether the reverse function is applicable with the tuples or not. Reverse function and sort function, right? So this question demands for reverse a tuple. You want to reverse a tuple. Without using any function, there is no direct function of tuple reversing, right? But you have to reverse. The third point is first name, last middle name, and last name of 10% will be asked, and each of them will be kept in a tuple, and we can make, at last we have to make a list of tuples. So let's do these examples one by one. The first question was to convert a tuple into a list, right? Let's find out how to convert a tuple into a list. So we have t is equal to something, say for example 8, 7, 6, 8 or 9. T is equal to 8, 7, 6, 9. These are the four things in that value t. Now what I have to do, as per the question, I have to change this t into list. So I will write L is equal to list of list within t. We can write the syntax and solve this, right? Now let us find out whether this, let us print this L and find out whether this L is a list or a tuple. Now as you can see that the tuple has been changed to converted to list, right? Similarly, we can convert a list into tuple 2. Okay, let us find out. Let's write our list as R is equal to 67, 56, 45, right? Now I want to convert this list into a tuple. So T is equal to tuple, or T, or better, Q is equal to tuple. So tuple is another type conversion function like list. As you can see that the color has changed to violet color. So tuple, inside this tuple, I will pass R. Okay. And now let us find out what is q. A q is a tuple made up of list elements. The only thing is that this q is not mutable, it is immutable. Rather, r is mutable. You can change, add, delete, but you cannot make any addition deletion on q. So this was the first question, right? Now let us come to the next question. The second question of the exercise was write a program to input a tuple and reverse it. Let us find out how to solve the second question. Okay. So we have a tuple called T with values 8, 7, 6, 9 here, right? This is a tuple T having all these values. I want a reverse tuple. What I will do? I will write T is equal to, let me first find out the ID of T. ID of T is something this. Okay. Now I'm writing a T is equal to tuple. Inside this tuple, what I will do with t, I will slice it out and make it colon colon minus 1. Now if I am writing this, if I am entering, pressing enter, it has accepted. Now let me show what is the value of t right now. The t has been reversed. Dekh rahe ho na, t ko reverse kar diya humne. The t has been reversed. But let us find out the id of t. Let us find the ID of T. As you can see, as expectable, the ID has changed. Since the original tuple T has never been changed. The original value 67, 56, 45 at some memory location, which is 536, has never been changed. A new memory location at 600 has been created. 91600 has been created. Isn't it? So this has to be understood. Though you are reversing, but a new value, a new tuple is generated in the memory. A new area is allocated in the memory rather than having the same memory location, isn't it? So this has to be known. Now let us come to the third question. The third question itself is write a program to input first name, middle name and last name of 10% and create a list of tuples where each tuple has these three elements. So I'm going to create a file script mode program for this. What I will do, I will take mid, first name, mid name and last name as equal to blank, comma, blank, right? And then what I will do, I will input 10 times 10 different names, and I will create a tuple and add into a list. So I have to take a list, and in this list I will add those tuples, right? So for asking 10 times 10 different names, middle name and first name and last name, I have to carry out a loop. So I will use here a while loop. Maybe I is equal to 1, or you can use for loop as you want. Okay, so let us use for loop for I in range 0 to 10. Okay, for I in range 0 to 10, 10 times this will run. I will input first name, f name is equal to input, enter first name, and then similarly we will ask enter second name, middle name, and enter the last name, right? Middle name and the last name. And after asking these three things, I will make a tuple and add it into the list. So L dot append, I will use inside it. What I will do, I will write tuple, T-U-P-L-E, tuple. This type conversion function tuple you will be used, and within it I will pass f name. This syntax we have seen earlier in the class, f name comma m name comma l name. These three things will be passed here. A tuple will be made, and that will be appended in L, right? And after that I will come out of the loop and I will print the list of tuples are, and then I will just simply print what L, right? This L will be printed, isn't it? So this is how it goes on. Let us find out whether this program runs or not, executes or not. Name tuple, right? Enter the first name, Kamal. Kant Gupta. Now type error has got. We have got one type error is tuple expected at most one argument got 3. Now here we have tuple argument. Tuple is expecting one argument, but here we have got 3. So tuple function cannot be taken here as we have expected. So let's find out what is the error in this code. The error in this code is that we should not write tuple, because tuple is a type conversion function. It accepts only and only one argument. Here we have passed 3. So what we have to do is simply, you don't have to write any tuple here. Don't write tuple. Just place it within the parenthesis. These all three things in the parenthesis will make tuple, because we have syntax like T is equal to blank parenthesis. Just writing parenthesis will create a tuple. Tuple function is just for converting a list into tuple, or a single element into a tuple element, but not more than one argument. It does not accept more than one argument, and that is why the error was coming. So let us execute this code. So here it is. Enter the first name, Kamal, middle name, Kant Gupta. Enter the first name. This is for second person. This is for second person. So Sunita, Kumari, Gupta, and then Kabir, Kishore, Gupta. Suppose again it is asking middle name. So Siddharth. What happened? Again it will ask something. Now you see here what we have created. We have created list of tuples. Okay, so this question is okay, that we have created a list of tuples where each tuple is being added into a list, so that we can have a list of tuples, right? So here it comes, the end of this exercise example. I hope this exercise is clear to you. This is a code we have. Just let's look once more this code. We have m name, first name, m name, last name. We have keeping it initially blank. we have one list, blank list initially. Then we have executed our for loop for 10 times. For executing 10 times, we should write here 10, 0 to 10, that means 10 times. And then it will ask 10 times this fname, mname, and lname, and it will create a tuple with them by just putting them in a parenthesis bracket and adding that into the list using append function. And then after coming out of the loop, this loop will go for 10. These four steps will be executed 10 times for 10 different names. And then after coming out of the loop, we are just simply printing the list. Tuple comprehension. Now there is no tuple comprehension like as in case of lists. There is no direct syntax. There is no direct syntax for tuple comprehension. Remember. But a tuple comprehension can be performed by a method of a generator comprehension having syntax like. So we have something called as generator comprehension. We have something called as generator comprehension. Using this generator comprehension, we can create a tuple comprehension. Now the syntax is, for list we don't have to write, what this thing. For this list, we don't have to write here list, because this is no more list comprehension, it is generator comprehension. This generates an expression, an orphan expression, an expression without having any memory location. So what you have to do is, with this expression you have to apply tuple function over it, so that a memory location is being gained by this expression, is being gained by the value of this expression. And hence the generator comprehension is very important. Now you see here, example is there. I into I for I in range 1 to 11, and you keep this thing into the tuple, and then it will produce the tuple. That is the square of the first 10 natural numbers. Similarly, we can reverse tuple, as we have seen an example to reverse tuple, right? That was two lines of code. But here you can reverse a tuple using this syntax. And then again, this reversed function is using the generator expression. It is using generator expression to reverse this tuple. So whenever you are using a generator expression with tuple, you have to include this tuple keyword. So let us find out two examples related to tuple comprehension. We create a generator expression and comprehend it as a tuple. T is equal to tuple. And then here inside this tuple function, you have to, tuple type conversion function, you have to write the generator expression. And the generator expression is something. It is something like in bracket, you have to write I into I for I in range 1 to 11. Isn't it? Now, let us execute it. And the thing has been accepted. Let us print D. Now you can see that. It generates a tuple having squares of first n natural number, and this is being done by using generator comprehension with tuple function on it, right? So this is what is called generator comprehension. It is not list, like same as that of list comprehension. In case of list comprehension, we never write list function, we never use list function. We simply write like this list, and then within a square bracket, we write I into I, and then we just simply write for I in range 1 to 11. That's it. Okay, and then we print in. So this is a list comprehension. Now just compare these two things. Here, what is the difference between list comprehension and a generator comprehension using tuple function, right? So this is what we have. Now let us find out the reverse operation using generator expression. So using the generator expression, you can reverse the tuple. Now we have a tuple like this, square of natural numbers in T. We have T is equal to square of, let us reverse this from 100 to 1. So T is equal to reversed, and on this reversed we will apply tuple. Here in the reversed I will apply T and T over this, and then print this T. Now as you can see, it has been reversed simply. So in one line you can just simply reverse the thing. Okay, So this is what is called reverse, using reversed function. The function name is reverse, not reverse, that is reversed. Reversed function is used, and that too using generator comprehension. Now, class assignment. So all of you, please just take the screenshot of this class assignment that you have to perform today. All of you should do these two questions and send it by today evening. The first one is a program puts continuous digits between 0 to 9 and keeps it in word in a tuple. And the program should stop when the user inputs the digit 0 for the second time. When the digit 0 is inputted for the second time, then only the programs stop. For example, if the user inputs digits in sequence like 9, 6, 3, 0, 2, 4, 0, then the tuple will produce, the tuple produced will be 9, 6, 3, 0, 2, 4, and the for last 0 it will stop. For last 0 it will not include that last 0. Why? Because that last 0 is the second time 0 we are appearing. So for second time 0 the program should stop. Until unless then it will accept the values, the digits, and it will convert the digits into its word form and add into the tuple. And finally it will print this tuple. The second question is, divide the upper tuple given above, whatever is instead of the first question. The second question, what it does, it divides that tuple into two halves, such that first tuple will have the first half and the second tuple will have the second half, if the number of elements in the tuples are even. For odd number of elements, the first half will have first and second half will have equal number of elements, and middle we will have three tuples, and the middle one will have carry the middle element. Okay, these two questions are to be done as a class assignment for you. So with this, we are coming to the end of our class. Thank you, children, for this session.